What is that?
It is the first page of a new book, Your Majesty.
Let me see it. On the freedom of thought. Who wrote it?
Pierre Gringoire.
Gringoire? Who is he?
A French poet, Your Majesty.
A heretic, sir. To spread him is to communicate disease.
How do you know? It may be a great blessing to France if people can get books and learn to read. To me, it's a new form of expression of thought. Out there is the old form. All over France, in every city, there stand cathedrals like this one, triumphal monuments of the past. They tower over the homes of our people like mighty guardians, keeping alive the invincible faith of the Christian. Every arch, every column, every statue is a carved piece out of our history.
With a story like Notre Dame de Paris, you don't really have to explain much, you know. And if you read the novel, Victor Hugo's novel is very descriptive of what Paris was and what the cathedral was, and he describes the feelings and the desires, but there are very few dialogues in the novel, which it made it very interesting to turn it into an opera or a musical, because what those characters think and don't say, because they talk to each other very little in the actual story. You know? It's desire, hate, love, but it's all inside, so they all keep that inside. So it gives you beautiful subjects for songs, you know?
Il est venu le temps des cathédrales. Le monde est entré. A voulu monter vers les étoiles, écrire son histoire dans le verre ou dans la pierre. Pierre après pierre, jour après jour, de siècle en siècle avec amour, il a vu s'élever les tours qu'il avait bâties de ses mains.
For this undertaking, Luc Plamondon teamed up with long-standing friend and colleague Richard Cochante. Though Cochante was known in France as a singer-songwriter, his most recent reputation was as an accomplished composer. Nevertheless, a musical for Notre Dame de Paris was a tall order.
Notre Dame de Paris.
At the beginning, I wasn't completely convinced we should do Notre Dame de Paris. It was out of respect for the great author, Victor Hugo. I was afraid to fall into the trap of writing something pompous, too complicated, too intellectual. So I had to make myself think about it, to figure out in what direction to take it.
Il est venu le temps des cathédrales. Le monde est entré dans un nouveau millénaire. L'homme a voulu monter vers les étoiles. Foutu le temps des cathédrales, la foule des barbares est aux portes de la ville. Laissez entrer ces païens, ces vandales.
Everyone in Paris knows La Place des Vosges, where Victor Hugo lived for a good part of his life. From poetry to theater, plays and novels, Hugo amassed a formidable body of work. You've only to think of Les Misérables to understand how his work has inscribed itself into the collective memory and how it still speaks with a timeless resonance.
When you're talking about Hugo, you're talking about a very international author. This is a world book. It figures in world classics. It belongs to people in Bulgaria and Iceland. I don't think of Hugo as a particularly even French phenomenon. I think of him as a very 19th century phenomenon. But the issues he deals with, the dispossessed of the world, the poor, the gypsy, the deformed. He's not a Parisian author at all. In fact, he's a world figure. He was a kind of proto-ecologist, if you like. He did care about history. He cared about buildings and the relationship between people and environment, as we would say. He tells you so much about architecture in the first pages of Notre Dame. The general public's view of those lovely old medieval narrow streets and so on was that they were dirty and uncomfortable. I think Hugo is unfashionable in thinking that they had not just charm, but they were the essence of Paris. He's a very visual kind of writer, I think. It's not unusual that Hollywood, say, would be attracted to Hugo. There are several films of what we call the Hunchback of Notre Dame.
That girl, what a beauty. I've never seen her before, have you?
She is pretty.
The basis of the novel is melodrama. You have an innocent gypsy who is beautiful with a goat.
Who is she?
At least three men, and possibly half of Paris, are in love with her. One is a repressed, sexually repressed priest, another is a deformed hunchback in the cathedral, who lives in the cathedral and rings the bell. He's a bell ringer by trade, and he's deaf. And the other is an impecunious poet who's a bit like Hugo himself. Hugo does, as he will do later with Les Misérables and with other novels, is he takes what is basically a vulgar, in a sense, given subject matter and elevates it because of the sheer infectious poetry and descriptions, writing, ideas. It's full of ideas. So it's a large, messy kind of work. It's not a well-written classic in the sense that Flaubert is a well-written classic. It's a big, sprawling, what Henry James, referring to Russian novels, called a loose and baggy monster. This is a loose and baggy monster, all right.
Notre Dame de Paris only through the movies and the ballets and So I read the book, and I noted the ideas of songs in the margin of the book. And at the end of the book, I had at least 20 songs started. You know? I had found a way of writing it like it was a story about today. All the outcasts who are excluded from the city of Paris, the sans-papiers, you know, the ones without papers, the ones, the illegal immigrants, actually. In their millions in France, like there are millions everywhere in the world. They occupied a church in Paris in the name of the right of asylum, which is very important in Victor Hugo's novel, you know, when Quasimodo saves Esmeralda from being hanged and takes her to the cathedral. He keeps her inside the cathedral and screams, "Asylum, asylum." So so in the name of the right of asylum, those people occupied the church Saint Bernard in Paris. And for the first time in history, the police broke in. So that right of asylum was sacred through centuries. And that happened right at the moment where I was starting writing my opera.
Peut-être qu'on en aura besoin de plus long aussi. Ça, faut voir avec Gilles.
On a senti tout de suite quelque chose de très fort.
Right away, we both felt very strongly about it. Luc and I had often written together, and we both immediately felt that we had the strength within us to allow us to write this work. And this lasted right up to the production.
La réalisation, lorsque on a contacté Gilles Maheu.
When we contacted Gilles Maheu, it wasn't immediately obvious that he was right for directing Notre-Dame de Paris. Though he is a stage director, his work tends to be avant-garde. And yet, he turned out to be exactly right, and it worked out beautifully.
Gilles Maheu's work is recognized in Quebec and around the world. He founded the troupe Carbon 14 and has directed works that have marked the world of drama this century. Le Dortoir and Skin, Flesh and Bone. But for a rock opera, at first the match didn't seem perfect.
I don't know too much about musical, you know. I've seen a couple, but I want to bring my own work of avant-garde inside of the musical universe, you know. And sometimes I found that musical are a little bit over kitsch, etc., and that they over using the staging. And I didn't want to do that. I want to work it more like at the opera. it's very naked stage, you know, which is different for the genre, you know. But that was, for me, very important because the songs are very strong, and I didn't want, as a stage director, to take power to the singers. I want them really to give the emotion to the public, and bringing, of course, the idea of the avant-garde, which is, I think, very important, because there's a lot of people who don't know those currents and that they will discover it through that work.
That's another difference between my musicals and, let's say, Andrew Lloyd Webber's musicals or Claude-Michel Schoenberg's musicals. They're people I respect very much, that I know very well, and but they use what they call the theatrical singers, you know, the Broadway-style singers. And I use pop singers, rock singers, blues singers.
Quasimodo est malheureux. Quasimodo est amoureux.
Cochante's inspiration is really opera. But these music sung by rhythm and blues singers or rock singers or pop singers becomes very interesting.
Cathedrale, Quasimodo est malheureux. Quasimodo est amoureux.
I have a solo career, pop singer in Quebec, and to do opera rock, it gives other kind of exposure in France and other kind of experience on the scene. So we have to play a lot and be different than what we are in the pop singer style.
Là-bas, ce monstre n'est-il pas celui qu'on élira? Le pas des fous, le pas des fous, celui qu'on élira, celui qu'on élira, le pas des fous. C'est le sonneur de cloche avec sa bosse au dos, c'est bien lui le plus moche, c'est le Quasimodo. Voilà en plus qu'il a la belle Esmeralda, bossu, boiteux et bande, c'est lui qu'on élira. Le pas des fous, le pas des fous, c'est lui qu'on élira, c'est lui qu'on élira. Quasimodo, c'est lui qu'on élira, c'est lui qu'on élira. Le pas des fous.
Montez-lui, le pape des fous, c'est aujourd'hui le jour de la fête des rois, et pour un jour cela me donne tous les droits. M'aimeras-tu, Esmeralda, m'aimeras-tu?
Quasimodo is naive, is really sensible. On a show like this, you have to concentrate on something. And I wanted to concentrate more on the naive Quasimodo and the sensible with Esmeralda. For me, that's how it is.
qu'à venir demander asile dans ma maison à moi. Il fait toujours beau, l'hiver il fait moins froid.
And that was the story, the beauty and the beast and the beauty and the ugliness, which always fascinate me. And that's also what Luc developed on his work, on his adaptation of Hugo, the desire between this ugly man and his inside beauty and this beautiful woman.
On a tout ce que je veux, I'm really getting into the Quasimodo, you know. Every day on the makeup, they're making me a little hunched there. And this week, I've had a real one. It was so funny. I'm getting the character, you know. It's like physically it's rough, but even the way we sing is tough, singing in that position of Quasimodo. But it's more emotionally. Quasimodo is hard to play. So if you want to really give it, you gotta take it out of you.
Hello, Maru.
I found him almost by accident because he was singing in a bar in Magog. He was a rhythm and blues singer with his own band and sang in different bars in through Quebec. And had been doing that for 6-7 years. But he was only 22, 23 when I found him 3 years ago. Incredible showman.
He saw me doing that rhythm and blues, soul, rock stuff.
You know?
And he came to me and he proposed maybe something in his next musical, but I didn't knew him. It was for Notre Dame de Paris and of course not for Quasimodo. And when I think about it, it's so strange because I know today that Luc wanted me for Quasimodo. It's strange that he saw that I could do this.
Pitié pour le pauvre Quasimodo qui porte déjà sur son dos tous les malheurs du monde qui ne vous demande une goutte d'eau. Pitié, Bado, pour votre Bado, une goutte d'eau pour Quasimodo. À boire. Donnez-moi à boire. À boire.
My voice is rough, so physically I had to do something else completely to have that mystery of Quasimodo, because he lived inside Notre Dame de Paris all his life long.
Les cloches que je sens sont mes amours. Sont mes amants. Je veux qu'elle plaira, qu'elle t'en mourir et qu'elle chante. Qu'il grève.
Of course, one needed imagination to think of him for Quasimodo, but that's what. I mean, I don't know, but that's the kind of talent I have, I guess, because I've always found great singers for my musicals, and we're not always obvious.
De les voir si joyeux, de les voir si heureux, moi qu'aucune femme ne regardera jamais dans les yeux. De les voir convoler, de les voir s'envoler, au milieu des étoiles sous la voûte des cieux. Toutes ces cloches que je sens, qui riaient et les sales, aux Andes, alléluia, qui tirait d'ici là. Toutes ces cloches de malheur, toutes ces
I found Bruno Pelletier in 92. He was also a bar singer, a rock singer. In the meantime, he has become the number one singer in Quebec, and he's playing Gringoire in Notre Dame de Paris.
Bateaux sont partis déjà sur l'océan.
Le choix des voix fait partie aussi de la musique.
Choosing the right voices is a very important part of making the music. So we got together with Luc to choose the singers. We wanted voices that were neither operatic nor typically Broadway in style. But voices that sing in a natural manner, and yet still with a wide vocal range. That wasn't easy to find.
Here,
a lot of singers tend to express themselves more with the lyrics and with their character rather than with a real vocal style. And I believe that the Québécois have kept this focus on the voice, this desire to sing, and this remained in their tradition. It's the same in Italy, but unfortunately in France we had some difficulty. On the other hand, thanks to Notre Dame de Paris and certain singers like Céline Dion, young singers are showing a desire to start using their voices again and to really sing.
I wasn't expecting this at all. You know, I've had an up and down career. I've had great success and great flops. And I was sort of laying back lately, just writing music for other people and writing music for films and things like that. And then all of a sudden this comes along and I'm out in the spotlight again. I'm just, I think it's fun this time. I'm the bad guy, and without the bad guy, you have nothing, right?
Right.
So I get to make everyone die at the end, including myself.
Sur la place de grève, sur l'Esmeralda, c'est elle que l'on prend dans le jour qui se lève.
When you become a singer, you sort of like want people to like you, you know. And when you have a role like this, you know you've made it if they hate you. So the contradiction is kind of little, took me a little while to get used to.
Je te donne le choix avant le petit jour. C'est la vie ou la mort, c'est la tombe ou l'amour, c'est la vie. C'est-à-dire oui, si je te sors d'ici, je promets que je te rendrai à tes frères les gitans. tes frères en t'attend.
Va-t'en, va-t'en, va-t'en.
Luc has known priests very well and managed to give me another perspective than Victor Hugo. Victor Hugo made Frollo much meaner than myself, than the Frollo that I play. He's given me a lot of places to buy myself back. He's giving me some songs where I can excuse myself.
Je vivais loin des femmes, flagellée dans ma chair. Quand au cœur de la nuit ce fut comme un éclair. Distrait de ma prière, j'ai ouvert la fenêtre. Au matin qui se levait pour te voir apparaître. Oh, être prêtre et aimer une femme, l'aimer, oui l'aimer, de toutes les fureurs de son âme.
I think people do recognize themselves in the role that I play, because I try to make him very human. I try to make his weaknesses very similar to everyone's weaknesses.
Moi qui me croyais l'hiver, me voici un arbre vert. Moi qui me croyais de fer contre le feu de la chair. Je m'enflamme et me consume pour les yeux d'une étrangère. Qui en vient plus de mystère que la lumière de la lune. Tu vas me détruire, tu vas me détruire. Et je vais te maudire jusqu'à la fin de ma vie. Tu vas me détruire, tu vas me détruire. J'aurais pu le prédire dès le premier jour, dès la première nuit. Tu vas me détruire, tu vas me détruire, tu vas me détruire. Tu vas me détruire. Tu vas me détruire. Tu vas me détruire. Tu vas me détruire.
The spectaculars are there when it's needed, and but the rest of the time I really want to give the power to the singers. And that's why you need very good singers for that, because and we have in that show very good singers. And for me it was really important, like in a Greek tragedy, to that the emotion of the lyrics pass through when it's important and not distract by the idea of the director.
I discover many things about me, because before this experience I was a little shy with people. So every night I have to see this 4,000 persons. But the more difficult was to be provocatrice at the beginning of the show. It's not a side of me, so I have to think about it. And after, it was to become sad when she was sad, to become dramatic when she was dramatic.
J'ai passé toute mon enfance, pieds nus sur les monts de Provence. Pour les gitans, la route est longue, la route est longue. Continuerai mon errance, bien sur les chemins de France. Je les suivrai au bout du monde, au bout du monde.
It was very exciting because I never did this kind of thing. I never danced. I never been in a big stage like this. It's very, very new for me. So I'm not actress. I'm just a singer, and I have to think, what can I do to be Esmeralda? So I try to think, this is Esmeralda, but she's like you.
Bohémienne, je suis fille de grand chemin. Bohémienne, bohémienne, qui peut dire qui j'aimerai demain?
Notre-Dame de Paris is one of the greatest things that ever happened to me, and it's a huge show. It's a great opportunity because in French we don't get to be able to sing, dance, play all at once. There was a show for Luc Plamondon at Les Francophonies de Montréal. I was to sing one song from his first rock opera, Starmania. And at one point, he said, he told Gilles Maheu, this guy could be a good Clopin. What if our Clopin was black? He could be a very good Clopin. He can move on the stage, he sings well. And when he told me, I wrote a play, it's on Notre-Dame de Paris, and the role is Clopin, here's what the role is all about. I liked it already. Man, I was really flattered. I was that small when he told me.
On est tous des frères, dans la joie, dans la misère. Vous ne trouverez chez nous ni le ciel, ni l'enfer, ni le ciel, ni l'enfer. Nous sommes comme des vers, comme des vers dans le ventre pourri de la terre. Le sang et le vin ont la même couleur.
Clopin is ease of all times. He exists because injustice exists. So wherever you'll find injustice, there's a Clopin. Sometimes the names could be Che Guevara, the names could be Nelson Mandela, but that's what Clopin is. He's a man that's trying to regain something for his people.
À la cour des miracles, à la cour des miracles, les filles de joie dansent avec les voleurs. À la cour des miracles, à la cour des miracles, mon corps est brigand dans la même danse. À la cour des miracles, à la cour des miracles, puisque nous sommes tous des gibiers de potence. À la cour des miracles, à la cour des miracles, à la cour des miracles, à la cour des miracles. Volant du nord.
toute l'œuvre est basée sur plusieurs.
The musical is based on several tunes, and among these, several could become hits afterward. This makes it different from other great musicals like Cats and Evita. These are splendid works which I admire a lot, but they contain fewer songs that could become hits and fit into the mainstream of popular music.
The hit single Belle sold millions and is the undisputed reason for the show's phenomenal success. At performances, there is a virtual tidal wave of appreciation, and the love affair shows no signs of losing steam.
Alors je sens l'enfer s'ouvrir sous mes pieds. J'ai posé mes yeux sous sa robe de gitane. À quoi me sert encore de prier Notre-Dame?
Another big difference from other musicals is that we started by launching the CD 8 months before the show opened.
Je pose mes yeux sur ta robe de gitane. À quoi me sert encore de prier? Dieu, et celui qui lui jettera la première pierre, celui-là ne mérite pas d'être sur terre. Oh Lucifer, oh laisse-moi rien qu'une fois glisser mes doigts dans les cheveux d'Esmeralda.
It's been such an incredible hit here. We've had so much feedback from people. They love us, really do. They made us on. They live by this show. They know all the songs, everyone.
I think people are touched in the heart. They feel a sad emotional, a happy emotion, but it's emotions for us. And for a moment, they forget the life. They are in a dream. And after the show, they stay like this. They are very, very touched.
Either I was going to become a singer, but when I was like 20, 21, I had to think about what I was going to do with my life, and that thing was becoming like a dream that I was, but it didn't seem realistic, and I loved Jacques Brel and Bob Dylan, people like that, and I knew I was not a Jacques Brel or Bob Dylan, so I went on writing songs in secret. Fortunately, I was given a chance to hear my lyrics set to music by good composers and song by good singers, and I realized the difference. I mean, life chose for me. The fact is that Gilles Mahle's staging has appealed a lot to all the producers who came to see the show in Paris. Everybody wants the show as it is, which is great. So we just have to do now, like all the big producers from Broadway, when they take a musical and restage it all over the world.
Whatever what you do, you always want to reach people. I think that in my own work, I always have something very popular inside of it, very emotional, you know, even if I was in the avant-garde. My work is not cold, I think it's warm. And it's connected, I think, to, in my mind, it was connected to everyone. With the words of Luc and the music of Richard, we suddenly reach 1 million person just this year, and I think it's, for me, it's absolutely fantastic.
I think I'll remember it all. It's a big, big adventure for us, and it's not over, because after this, there's Notre Dame in English, there's other Notre Dames.
Il est fou si le temps est cassé là.